Hello people, yes, I've decided, you know what, I'm gonna play some of these like foreign Euro demos that I just haven't got around to playing yet. So this is Euro Demo 20 France, or Euro Demo France 20, or however I'm gonna title the video. You can tell it's French just from looking at that. I know I can't read it. And as you can see, we've got this old school Pale Line logo with a P on it. So you can tell this demo is old. Yeah, I think this was released sometime around, like, I'm not sure, around May 1998 or June 1998, something like that. And this demo was released, well, there was no Euro Demo 19 for some reason in France, because there was Euro Demo 20, there was Euro Demo 18, sorry, and then there was this, and this skipped Euro Demo 19 for some reason. And yeah, it's great to see this interface again. After seeing all those like really high numbered demos that don't have this interface. And yeah, not a whole lot of stuff on this. I mean, the last thing I looked at had like 12 different things on it, Euro Demo 100, and this has 6. But anyway, if you see what's on here, we've got Dead Ball Zone, Forsaken, Cooler World, Newman Haas Racing, which I'm pretty sure is meant to be Newman Horse Racing, but whatever. Terra Cognita and the Incredible Cone Man, which are Net/Your Aussie games, and Net/Your Aussie Video. So let's just get this started with Dead Ball Zone. Yes. Now, I seem to remember this game, and I remember this is like a really weird, like futuristic sports game. Also, I remember I haven't got a clue how to play this, so this is going to go really badly. In fact, this will. Well, it's actually in French. But yeah, this is probably going to go even worse than the ISS game that I played on the last demo. I love that, by the way, DBZ. Totally doesn't look like something else that has the initials DBZ. Yeah. Oh no, 7 what? Okay, well. Yeah, well, obviously we're going to go against the computer, even though I'm going to absolutely suck at this. I mean, it's a sports game, so what do you expect? I like those in French, though, that's pretty cool. Oh, I just got the ball. Oh, I haven't got a clue what to do. Oh, okay, so I didn't. Okay, so that managed to somehow not score there. Okay, I have no idea how to play this. Because the problem is, it's like, they don't tell you the controls, so it's like, yeah. Yeah, no, we don't need a replay. How do you skip the replay anyway? I have no idea. Okay, well, I pressed triangle and it seemed to work. So the problem is, I have no idea how to control this. It's like, because the problem is, it's like, just like the ISS game, they don't tell you the controls at the beginning, so it's like you have no idea how to play it. As you can see. I'm really sucking at this. But I want to see if I can get somewhere with this game. And, okay. It's like I just mash all the buttons and it eventually skips the replay, as far as I can tell. Okay, and the opponent got the ball at time. This isn't, yeah. This is going pretty much how I expected, as in it is going disastrously. Yeah, fuck it. I'm not going to bother. Because I haven't got a clue how to play the game. They don't tell you how to play the game, like, at all. I mean, the Riot demo at least told you, like, the controls for it. But yeah, I haven't got a clue how to play that, so I'm just going to skip it. So let's move on to Forsaken. Now, this is a game I do know how to play, because I remember I played this before in one or two other demos, I think. I'm not totally sure. I know I've played this before. I'm not sure if I did it on a video. I remember this game's quite cool, though. Because it's like a first-person shooter. And there we go. Acclaim. Yeah, Acclaim made a... they actually made some good games around this time. Because they made, like, the Buster Move games. Well, they didn't make them, but, you know, they ported them, at least. And they made, like, Turok for the Nintendo 64. And they made Alien Trilogy. Well, they didn't make that one, but I think Probe made it. But that was a cool game. And this game's probably cool as well. I'm sure they made this one themselves, unless I missed something. I wasn't really paying attention to the copyright stuff, so. And apparently the controls have decided not to work. Great. See, this is the problem with these old demos. It's like the controls don't work when you want them to. Okay, now they seem to work. Okay. Problem is, I don't quite remember how the controls work. I don't remember how you shoot. Okay, it's L1. Just like the Quake 2 demo, actually, which is kind of weird. Unfortunately, this gun is nowhere near as effective as the super shotgun in that game. And the enemy just appears out of nowhere. Doesn't help when the enemies just dodge everything, so you can't actually. So look at this. I'm nearly dead already. This is ridiculous. Or at least the shield's almost down. See, actually, you know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of Descent. Because I've got that on PS1. That's a pretty cool game. At least I like it. Like, some people say it sucks, at least on PS1. And this is not going well. I've already lost my shield. And I'm sure there's going to be another enemy that spawns from here. Oh, maybe not. I don't really see the point in the gold, though. Because all I want is health. So I can actually get somewhere. And I'm sure I've beaten this demo before in a video. I just can't remember what video. So I don't remember this appearing on any of those like high number demos. I'll just shoot that. How do you switch weapons? I promise I've completely forgotten the controls. It's been a while since I've played this. Cause I mean, I don't even have the game. I just played this demo a few times and that was it. So we go tank down. Tango down? Yeah. I don't know why you want to take down Tango. I mean, what's wrong with Tango? I mean, if you gotta take down something, at least take down, like, RC Cola or something. Something dumb like that. Oh, there's a tank up here. Yeah. So we go. And I know there's another tank around here that's gonna try shooting me. Yeah. I promise I'm out of. Okay. Apparently it takes less shots than a four. Promise, I don't remember how to change the weapons. Okay, okay, it's square, and I think I could switch the other thing. The sus gun. For YouTube poop needs. Yeah. But I'm just gonna have this one equipped, because it's cooler. At least I think it's cooler. Oh, promise, I think my biggest complaint with this game is you can't really tell what the enemies are a lot of the time. It's like, because it's like, everyone's game is like really small compared to the environment. I don't know. It just feels kind of weird playing it. But hey, at least I can actually get somewhere with this game on like the dead ball zone thing where I just keep, where I just like, could see goals every 2 seconds. Oh, didn't die from that? Oh. Okay, so we go. No. The hell's the enemy? No, sod you! Okay, just die. Okay. Switch the gun, actually, because I don't think I really need the good gun at this point. I just need a gun. Or something like that. So there's an enemy right there. Gotta learn to dodge all this stuff. No, with the. Oh, I thought there was a pill up here, unless I collected it. I must have, because I got full shield. Oh, I remember this. You're a goof. Yeah. You don't go in the lava, because otherwise you die, I think. Or you just take lots of damage. I don't remember. Okay, that enemy is down. There's another one right here. See, I upgraded my gun, which is pretty cool. And I know there's a way. I'm not sure if it's like a secret. What the hell? Oh. Okay, I must have missed this one. Don't know how I missed it, but I did. But I know there's, like, another room you can go into here, but I don't remember, like, I don't know how to get to it. It's just, sometimes you can go in it, sometimes you can't. And it seems like one of the times where I'm not going to be able to go in it. Because these, see how easy, you can see you can go in there. But yeah, I can't go through. And that sucks. But let's just move on. I've only just noticed like the music, because it's so quiet you can barely hear it. I remember this is annoying. Because you got all these like invisible enemies that try to get you. And it's annoying. No, give me that. No, give me the shield, okay? Don't give me invisible enemies where I can only like see them when they crash into me. I need all the shield I can get with this game. Okay. The controls on this are quite good, actually. Because I remember in Descent, it didn't actually support analog. Because, you know, the game was from, like, 1996. So, I mean, we'll do... Seriously, where the hell are these enemies? See, like, this is the most annoying thing about this, is where you got these, like, invisible enemies, and you don't see them until they, like, crash into you or something. It's annoying. It's the problem I have with this, and I need that. Okay. So, yeah, let's switch to the other gun. I just want one that's got, like, good spread fire. So we go down... Oh. Yeah. Eat that. Whoa. He's mean business. Okay. What about the hell the enemies? Oh. Okay. The hell? I don't see any more enemies around here. Maybe there's some, like, invisible enemies trying to kill me again. Oh no. But I know you have to go into this room down here. Oh. There's one. There's another one. And there's... I don't get this, like... It's kind of weird how, like, the enemies always seem to appear out of nowhere. You know, it's like, there's no enemies, and then a few seconds later, like, a million enemies just appear out of nowhere and kill you. I'm pretty sure, like, they can't even come from those, like, duct things. It doesn't even make any sense. Where the hell's... Oh. Okay, so I finally got some shield. Even though, okay, when I'm about to die, I finally get some. Great. So we gotta go through here. I desperately need... Oh, just let me through, you stupid door. Okay. The hell's the health at? I need health, goddammit. I can't live on shield alone. See, it doesn't help when you got, like... When the enemies are just, like... Yeah. Doesn't help the enemies are just, like, firing 50 bullets at a time. And it doesn't help when you can't actually find anything to, like, heal yourself with. So this is the problem, that you can't, like... Ugh. Okay. It's like the enemies just always appear out of nowhere with this game. So give me that. See, if I can get through here, I might be able to beat this level. Because I remember after this, you just got, like, dodge stuff. And then, like, that's it. So I'm gonna try to rush. I'm gonna try to rush through this bit. And don't stop shooting at me, you git! You know, I'm gonna tell this guy to sod himself. And of course, I don't get any pelps on him because he's a git. And I died. Okay, let's just quit. Because I don't feel like watching the die animation because I just can't be bothered. Hopefully the controls won't break when I go back to the menu, even though they most likely will, because I need to use the analog controls for that game. Yeah. So let's see what else we've got. Let's see if I can find a game that I don't completely suck at. Okay. Well, at least I'll be able to beat one game on this demo. Because, yeah. I don't think you can actually beat the Neiman Haas Racing 1. I don't know. Maybe you can. I don't know. Yeah, Cool World, like, which is by far the best game on this disc, because, you know, there's not really much competition. I mean, you've got, like, a sports game that doesn't make any sense, a first-person shooter that's, like, it's alright, but it's, you know, there's much better shooting ups on PS1. The Quake 2, for instance. And, a racing game, which is, like... I don't know, I think it's like indie or something. I don't know. I don't know much about American racing, so I couldn't really tell you. But yeah. Now this is... I remember I played this demo all the time back in the day. Because I had this... At least I think I had Demo 16 Volume 2. Because I definitely remember playing this demo. And I don't think I really bothered with anything else on it, because... You know, there wasn't really anything else on that demo that was really worth playing, in my opinion. Because, I mean, there was, like, two football games on it. And then there was, like, Dead Ball Zones on it as well. Which, you know, as you already saw at the beginning, I haven't got a clue how to play it. Okay. And then we've got... there was, like, a pinball game. Forsaken was on there as well. Oh, damn. Okay, apparently I missed the fruit. Which is brilliant. Oh well, it's like the entire demo. But yeah. Like I said, Cool World, really good game. Although, I have to say, I do have this game, and it's really difficult, actually, later on. It's like you get to, like, level, I don't know, 40 or so, and then it just gets really hard, from what I remember. So now we have Newman Haas Racing, or whatever the hell racing it is. But yeah, I figured I should record some of these French demos, because I have about half a dozen of these, and I've only recorded one of them before, which was Euro Demo 24. And I remember that one, because it was the one that had Tombi on it. I think it also had the Fifth Element for some reason, even though that game sucked, but what are you going to do? But yes, I do want to see if I can record some more of these French demos, although I'm probably not going to be able to record any, like, now, because I'm, you know, I'm at my dinner. Now I'm not interrupting my dinner just to play more demos, you know. Yeah, my dinner takes priority. Okay, so it's... Okay, the controls feel kind of loose on this. Okay. Oh! Oof. Okay. Made the turn. Yeah, I remember this game. I played it before. Well, at least I played this demo before. I never owned the game. But yeah, I don't think I've ever played this demo as a kid, though, because I don't remember having 15 Volume 2. I mean, the rest of the games were on 16 Volume 2, but this was on 15, I think. And, yeah, I don't remember owning that one. Maybe it's just because there aren't any games out there really noteworthy. I mean, the best game on it is, like, Motorhead, which is a pretty cool game. But the demo kind of sucks, because you only get to do, like, one lap, which is really lame. Okay. Let's see if I can get some over this. I mean, I'm in 10th right now, so... See, the problem with this is that it's really low res, so you can't really see where you're going. I mean, that's the problem with, like, the PS1 in general, but especially with this game. Because it's like you have to know the course layout. And I don't think even that would help very much, because it's like... The problem that I have with this is there's no real distinct, like, features with it. I mean, like, Monaco... You know, you got that, like, 180 degree turn thing down the hill. Yeah. That idiot crashed in me. I don't get, like, why does the camera, like, zoom out whenever you crash in someone? It's weird. But let's see if I can hold on to my 10th place right now. Probably not, but we'll see. Oh, look at that. Okay, so apparently you got reverse with circle. I don't really get that. I don't get why the car just make reverse and, well, brake and reverse the same button. I mean, I'm used to that with a lot of games. I don't know why. So other games I play just tend to have that control scheme. And it works, in my opinion. You know. But yeah. See what I can get with this. Ooh. Oh, you bugger. Of course the car just spins out like a twat. Oh, I'm just gonna spin out for no reason. Yeah. Oh no. I gotta say, I really prefer Formula One, personally. Like, maybe this is a good game, it's just... Yeah, I don't know. I'd rather just play a Formula One game, personally, but that's just my opinion. I can't really say it's a bad game, though. It's just, I don't particularly care for it. There we go, end of demo. And that's it. And go to all... Okay, what the hell? Like, I didn't even press anything there, it disappeared immediately. It's like, it doesn't even give you a chance to read it, which is really weird. But yeah, we're done with that. So let's look at the Netuazi video. Okay. Okay, again, there was no sound there when I selected the thing. I mean, I remember that happened last time when I played Eurodemo 100 and, like, the same messed up ones. And, okay, what the hell's the sound on this? Like, there's no music. It's like, because I remember these videos had music on them. Because, yeah, there's some really cool music as well. I mean, I'm sure there's videos of this on YouTube where they'll, like, show you the video. I mean, obviously, like, this is in French, and I'm pretty sure the videos of this would be in, like, English. Because, you know, most of the Euro demos, or most places where the Euro demos were sold, they were usually, like, the English ones. But this was, like, you know, I mean, this was obviously sold in France. And then there were some other ones that were sold in Germany. And, you know, I'll look at those at some point. I mean, I've looked at some of the German demos before. If from like 1997, I think. And there we go, The Incredible Cone Man. And also Terra Incognita, which is pretty awesome. But apparently there's no option to play this in French, which will be pretty disappointing if you're French. But of course I'm not, so... Yeah, it's kind of weird playing a French demo and the Let's Plays in English. But then again, like, there's so many... You know, I mean, there's so many games. Like, I've seen so many times where there's, like, Let's Plays, and it'll say, like, Let's Play so-and-so, and the title will be in English, but then the Let's Play itself will be in, like, a completely different language. And I'll be like, what the hell's this guy saying? Okay, I can't understand them. Because, obviously, I mean, I can only speak English. Yeah, I can't read this apart from the, you know, address. But, yeah. And I don't get, like, where the sound is on this. Like, I'm not sure if the demo messed up and supposed to be sound on this and there just isn't. Oh no, it's crashed or something. I think it crashed because it's like stuck. Oh, okay. No, it quit, I think. I'm not sure if that's just because I was mashing buttons or if it just quit by itself. I don't know. You're asking the wrong person. But there we go. Cool. It's kind of a shame they got rid of that Powerline logo actually because it's like the coolest looking one, I think. But anyway, yeah, now we've got Terra Incognita and The Incredible Cone Man. It's pretty cool that you got like two games on the same disc from this time. Because I remember Euro Demo 37 in Europe, you know, in the UK, I should say. You know, they had like Psycon and Pushy 2. And, yeah. So we're going to start with Cone Man. I'm not going to play through these games. I'm not even sure if you could beat Cone Man, to be honest. I mean... Maybe you can, but I don't think so. But yeah, as I see, we're just waiting for this to load. Yeah. Lost Bastard. Great name right there. Running in 3 weeks. And I remember this game, because I remember I used to play this on the NetEurosy compilation that I had. You know, for Euro Demo 42, the Metal Gear Solid demo, there was... Now, you're also a compilation with it, which was really cool. Unfortunately, this wasn't really one of the big games on it. It was kind of... Honestly, this game... I know, it's kind of lame, to be honest. I don't really care for it. Because it's like a... It's supposed to be like a 3D Pac-Man clone. It's not really a particularly good one, though. Because it's like, you know, in Pac-Man, you know, you move... You know, it's like you move in four directions. It's like, you know... You press, like, up, and then you move up on in the game. But it doesn't really work like that in this game. It's like, yeah, you have to move around like it's a first-person shooter or something. It just, oh no, I don't really like it. You know, it's like I'd much rather just play Pac-Man. Because, you know, Pac-Man's a classic game. Or, you know, Ms. Pac-Man. I mean, I've got that game on the Mega Drive, and that's a classic game. And the Mega Drive itself is awesome, so, yeah. But yeah, I'm going to beat this. Well, I'm probably going to beat this level now. I'm just going to quit. But there's no guarantees on that. And yeah, now I'm... okay, well, I'm dead right here. So let's just quit out of that. Because it's time to play a better game right now. Terra Incognita International. I don't know why it calls it that. I mean, usually it's just Terra Incognita. But I think this was released in Japan originally. And then they released it in Europe, I guess. Yeah, here we go. Team Fatal Presents. Yes. It's kind of funny how, like, most of these NetEurosy games were made in Europe, but this one was made in Japan. It's kind of weird. I'm guessing it's like there were a bunch of, like, other Japanese games, but they didn't bother to translate them. And after playing this game, I can kind of see why. I mean, just witness the brilliant translation right here. Let's just get my voice acting hat on right here. Here we come! Well, we'd better not to go, I guess. No kidding! What do you say at this point? I know a rumor that there is golden pedestal in the ancient ruins in this island. I know, but... they see, the treasure is protected by horrible monster. I am afraid that even you cannot safely return from there this time. We cannot prove such thing without doing anything. We have managed several times till now. Everything go well this time too. Alright, so, take care and go by yourself. No kidding! You must come with me, alright? No, I don't want to go! Please go by yourself. You are still a coward guy. But I am really, really scary. Well, I see. You keep eyes on the ship. Please come back soon. It will be quickly sunset. All right. Please promise. I may leave you alone if it gets dark. It's true. You are tenacious. I told you that I understood. So, take care. Good luck. So there we go. The masterful translation that got referenced in Adventure Game. And yes, Terra Incognita. This is kind of a classic game, but honestly, playing this now, there is some definite problems with it, I gotta say. I'm not sure if I'm gonna bother beating this game in this video. I might do, but we'll see. To make up for the shortcomings I had in all the other games on this. But there we go. Developed in Japan, obviously. Otherwise, you wouldn't have those names. And then, of course, they just happen to be living in, I don't know, Missouri? What the hell? Missouri, that's what I meant. Maybe the two states combined. Or something, I don't know. Whoa. So apparently I managed to walk with a box on my head. Okay, that's right, I need the other box too. Music on this is really cool. I think it's like stop music though, because I remember like the music changed when you get to the boss and it's like the same music that's on a Dog Tale actually. Of this, by the way. Yeah. I'm just gonna walk around with a box on my head. Yeah, this is my Halloween costume, actually. I'm just gonna walk around like that. Okay, and we're gonna open that, get the key. Yeah, you can get a whole bunch of those health potion things, but I'm not gonna bother with most of them. And actually, you know what this game reminds me of? It reminds me of Landstalker for the Mega Drive, which I do want to get that game, actually. But I just haven't bothered. There we go. Enemy down. Get a power recover item you can use with circle. Okay. Maybe I'll need that. Hopefully I won't. Because I know how to beat this game. I have actually beaten this game before. So let's see if I can do it this time. And what's funny is this game actually doesn't take that long to beat if you know what you're doing. So I'm going to do this. Yeah, good. Do that. Now there's this area, which I'm going to go to this briefly. I'm not going to do everything here, but yeah, I'm just going to do this. So I remember, yeah, you can push that, but you can't actually do anything with it. Isn't there a box here? I think you have to go like the other side to get the box or something. But I'm going to get the hot vessel down here. I'm not going to bother getting the other ones, because it's just too much of a pain to really bother. And I don't think I'm really going to need them anyway. Yeah, famous last words right there, but yeah. So as we slowly walk to the other thing. This is a pretty cool game though. I mean, yeah. As far as like 3D Net Yoroi games go, this is probably the best looking one actually. Except maybe Arena. I don't know, maybe that's better or not. I don't really remember. But I'm going to go up here. Oh, that's right, I need both of them. I keep making that mistake. But yeah, it's better to make that mistake than to lose entirely. Okay, so now we've got another enemy around here. Yeah, look at this. Yeah, you also notice, like, this sword has no range whatsoever. That's, like, the biggest problem I have with this game is, like, you have to be, like, literally right next to the enemy to actually hit them. Which is annoying. but yeah. So we gotta go here. We screwed up my depth perception right there with the camera, but now we got another power recovery item. Yeah. It just refills your health, basically. In case you're wondering. Now I think you can fill the health bar entirely if you get every single treasure chest or something. Something like that. So I'm gonna do it like this. Oof. Nearly walked off right there. Oh, you bugger. I hate this bit. So this part is annoying because you got like all these moving platforms to get across. And like as a kid, I can never figure out what to do here. And I'm playing this game now and actually knowing what to do. There's no way in hell I would have figured it out as a kid. So yeah, it's no wonder I never beat this back in the day. But we gotta wait for this. And yeah, there's a treasure chest down there. I'm not gonna bother with it though. Yeah, and you also have to get the timing down perfectly, otherwise you just get hit. See, this part is a real dick move right here, because it's like, how would you know to do that? Like, seriously. It's like, yeah, like I said, as a kid, I wasn't aware you could do that. And frankly, I don't blame my kid self. I mean, usually I would, but in the case of that, I'm not going to, because that was just, yeah. Like I said, it's a dick move by the game. Now we've got the key. We need that key to actually get to the next bit. I like the music. It almost sounds like something you get on like a game show or like maybe an episode of Chucklevision. I don't know. I have no idea what I'm talking about, but then again, I never do. So that's not much of a surprise there. Not going to go down there because actually, I think you need the box, don't you? So let's just go down here. Let's avoid the red blob because I don't feel like getting attacked by it. Yeah, there's various types of blobs, and it's like, wait, how come I haven't taken any damage, actually? Because I know I've got hit a couple of times, but I haven't taken any damage for some reason. That's kind of weird. Okay, no, oh. Yeah, I remember what you got to do here. Problem is, I remember it. Okay, I think that's how you do it. So I'm going to avoid this blue blob, because I know it's just going to kill me. Oh, yeah, I remember this. Actually, no, there's nothing there. I thought there was, because I know there's a bit where you like go into a cave and then get something. Yeah, I remember this bit. I don't remember if problem is, I don't remember if you can actually like get on the swing. Okay. You just have to get the timing down in order to do that. And then you gotta do, there's a treasure chest there, I'm not gonna bother with it. I'm not really going to bother with most of them, because most of them are just too annoying to really bother with. And then it's just like, I'd end up taking damage and have to use one of the recovery items. You know, it'd be a waste. You know what I'm saying? Okay, let's spit on the screen like an idiot. Okay. No, I don't want to do that. Okay. Oh no, I'm going to have to reset this bit. So this is kind of annoying when you got these stupid puzzles to solve and it's like you keep messing them up. So I'm gonna have to do that. Thankfully it resets, so it's all like, oh, you miss once and then you lose. And yeah, I just remembered what I'm supposed to do here. I've got to do it like that. But yeah, the reason I'm beating this is because I want to at least beat one game on this properly. You know, I don't look like a complete inept idiot like I usually do. And yeah. Notice how the music just changed up, and notice how it's like the same music that's in Dogtail. Yeah, just avoid that. Oh, yeah, that's right, you gotta wait for the fire to go away completely, avoid to take damage for some reason. Okay, and then we get this. Because you can never have enough of those, and okay, I finally took some damage. So it took long enough. But now we gotta fight against a boss. And if you remember when I played the Dragon Velour demo, and you had to fight that dragon thing, and they hit it in the head and whatever, yeah, this is like that, except the graphics are a lot worse. Also, it's like, the hit detection on this is completely fucked. Because it's like, you literally have to like run to its head in order to actually do any damage. Yeah, and also notice how fast this is. It's like... It's also annoying that you only get to face in like 8 directions. I mean, obviously, I mean, this game is made in like 1997, I think, so... I can't really blame the game developers for that, but it's... yeah. But this boss is way too easy, though, because, I mean, look at me... look at how much health I've got. So you gotta wait like half an hour before you can actually do anything. Yeah. If I remember correctly, this one doesn't take that many hits. Look at the... I mean, this hit detection is awful. Like, seriously. This is the one thing that really holds me back from saying that this is an... that this is, like, a really good game. Like, if they fixed the hit detection, this would be a really good game. But it's like, the hit detection is just... yeah, like I said, it sucks. And it's the one thing that I really hate about this game. But the rest of the game is good. So, you know. So there we go. I beat the boss thing. Never collect this. Finally get the golden pedestal. Let's bring this back to the port. Okay. Pretty cool music though. It's like the one good thing about Dogtail. Yeah. I'm being kind of unfair there, but yeah. See, this is a pretty cool game. It's just, you know, there's just some glaring problems with it, really. Also, like how, even though I've only been out here for like 10 minutes, it's like... yeah. But I remember how to do this. Yeah, so there we go. We do that. And then we gotta go back from where we came. Get back to where you once belong. Wait, okay, let's do that. Because I don't want to have to go through the whole game again. Just to get this again. You know. And yeah, the enemies respawn, as you might notice. Which is kind of annoying, but what are you gonna do? Then we go through here. Then we go through the other bit. So, I mean, everything resets. So, well, I mean, apart from, like, the treasure chests, I think, but yeah. So, as you can see, I've just beaten the game right there. Pretty easy. Beat it in, like, 10 minutes. Not very long RPG, is it? Too late! I believed that you were defeated, finally! The hell? Wow! Is this the golden pedestal? As you might have expected, I believed that you are sure to bring it back. Well, let's leave here before sunset. Please wait a second. Please let me take a look before we move. No. It would be okay if it is a little... please, please. No, you cannot. Oh, good job. Alas. No way. I'm very, very sorry. Yeah, great game right there. He just drops it around the water. Why is he shaking his head? What the hell's up with this? Is this a game or is it a Was Not Was song? Okay, you know, anyone who gets that reference, I don't think anyone's ever gonna get that reference. But there we go. And that's it. Terra Incognita. And I just beat it. And overall, I'd say this demo was alright. It's not great, but it's, you know, certainly much worse ones out there. I mean, Cooler World's really good. That Newman horse racing thing was decent, I think. Forsaken was alright. Dead Ball Zone, oh no, maybe that would be a good game if I knew how to play it. But they don't tell you how the controls or how to like actually play the game, so I can't really judge it. And this game is really cool, so yeah. Anyway, I will see you later, people. See you.